Welcome to Absolute Beginners, and we are going to Irithyll of the Boreal Valley. So attune the Chaos Bed Vestiges, your Pyromancy rings, have some protection against lightning, because the enemy we're going to tackle does lightning damage. Back to Volna's bonfire. And our first bonfire in Irithyll is to the left. Three places you can kill this enemy. One is here, one is at the end of the bridge after you pass through the Mirage Gate, and the other is downstairs in the swamp. Down below in the swamp. So your pyromancy should be powerful enough to take it out. Now, if you don't kill it here, it will catch up with you later on in the water below. Keep that in mind. Let's light the second bonfire. And we will be going back to the first bonfire to help Ceres continue with her quest line. We'll be going up there in a while. So let's head on back. You should find her summon sign on the ground, on the bridge. Just stand on it and activate it. Now notice when you go into another world to help someone, your Estus flasks lower by half. And your health bar diminishes. As we proceed in Irithyll, Creighton will invade us.
Thank you for your
as an NPC.
Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
So let's go to Firelink, talk to Ceres. We'll let the dialogue run.
I have not thanked you for your generous rescue. That dark spirit was one of Rosaria's fingers. Vile bastard offspring who lurk in the darkness. My sworn enemies. Fearsome invaders, to say the least. I would not have made it alone. You have my deepest gratitude.
And she gives a silver cat ring.
If you require help on your travels, I offer you my sign. Blessing of the moon upon your journey. If you require help on your travels, I offer you my sign.
Wearing the silver cat ring gives you fall damage. You don't take a lot of fall damage. At least from three stories height. So, attune the sacred flame, add these rings. Now, when you go to attack an enemy with a sacred flame, do not wait for an opportunity. Just cast it. It stuns the enemy, takes them down. Now the boss of this area, Pontiff Sullivan, detected our coming, and he has now sent out Boreal Knights. These are the shadowy figures you see. Pontiff retreated into the cathedral above. These are Pontiff's Boreal Knights that you'll see. Let's get some stamina with this shield. Take out the first Pontiff Knight. So, as we were saying, it stuns the enemy, takes them down. Let's go ahead to change our weight ratio. It's over 70%. So taking off the gloves would be okay. 68.5. That's all right. There's another enemy to the right of the steps, so we need to take out this one with the shield. That is dark damage it deals. Again, as soon as you are close to an enemy, just cast Sacred Flame. Don't wait for an opening. Now this gate is closed. Can't be opened from this side. So we'll be going around to get into that area. Here's the other enemy. Higher intelligence and faith you have, the more damage your pyromancy does. As mentioned, this build will be a melee build and pyromancy build. Not so much sorcery. And here's another Boreal Knight. Pontiff has set loose. is another enemy who casts flames, and flames track you, so you need to keep that in mind. There's two of them, one on top there, and one coming, some enemies. Can do a lot of damage. So we're going to switch one ring for the slippers, just for this section. Onwards, the game needs you to switch rings and weapons according to what enemy you have in front of you. Enemies are getting tough. Alright. I'll try and take out the one here with arrows. This moss protects you against frost damage. There will be two more Pontiff ladies coming down, and try to separate them. If you're new to Sacred Flame, what we recommend is before you even begin going through this area, just kill the first enemies where the bonfire is, so you're close by to the bonfire in case you die. But our advice would be as soon as the enemy gets close, you cast the flame. Do not wait for an opening, you will not find it. Now these steps to the left contains a crystal. And one of the railings can be broken. But we'll be doing this little section in a while. We need to light the bonfire first. And Pontiff, just release the Dancer of the Boreal Valley. Now, it is peculiar because we have already killed the Dancer. We did an early Dancer fight. So the creators did not program this alternative. Let's get the bonfire here. Do not sit at the bonfire, just light it. And we'll talk to Anri to continue his quest line.
Oh, I thought it might be you. Good to see you. I never managed to find Horace. But my duty must be done, even alone. As an unkindled Lord Seeker. For the children I knew, bless their souls. We all have our reasons, don't we? Please, take this. Recompense for my foolish request. And also a token of protection. May the flames guide your way. Ah, you are brave indeed, to face your duty alone. I would do well to learn from you. May the flames guide your way.
Let's check out the gesture he just gave us. We use G and F for the drop-down menu. And in here, in a corner, is Anri's assassin. Now, if you kill him, you will break Yuria's questline. We're going for Yuria's questline, the dark ending in the game. So we will not kill this assassin. There are two shortcuts to the pass. One is across there, the Iron Gate. And the other is another double door Iron Gate. So we need to open those, but first we need to go where the illusionary rail is. These enemies have tons of stamina. I'm going to take up Cathedral enemy with arrows. And if you stand behind that pillar, her casting will not detect you. She will drop the spell she is using. Doris Gnawing is the spell she was using. Let's drop down to get the staff. Open the door just in case something happens and you're trapped. So this is the Witch Tree branch staff. So basically the first section is complete. That leads to the bonfire, the central Irithyll. If you know what weapon to use against an enemy from here onwards, you'll rarely die. So practice Sacred Flame before you come into the area. It can be scary. And that's the first, that's one of the shortcuts to the boss. But the shortcut here is quicker from the bonfire, so we're always going to use this shortcut. It's a double iron gate. As you see, it's just straight up there. Right, once we get to this item and pick it up, the three enemies in the main center will activate. Let's check if they have left the main building. They have. So they will patrol the entire strip. So let's take this one out. Now when you notice those regeneration of your Estus flask. This usually happens when you take out an enemy with, I wouldn't say skill, but quickly enough. You'll always be rewarded with a flask. It has nothing to do with some other player lighting the bonfire. Now let's take out this enemy. Because don't forget, we are playing offline. Pick up this item. The item on top there will drop down from the boss area to pick it up. You can't get it yet. Let's go through this wall. we can finally sit at the bonfire. We will not be going through that central peripheral area again. We don't need to. There is a Covenant item here. Very difficult to collect. This little section is, you drop down from those parapets, you can't go up, so that will come later. The assassin is still there. It's time to go to Firelink. We need to talk to Yoria. Since we did not kill the assassin. And she will be down here. Let's put on a torch.
Speak thy desire, honorable Lord of Hollows. Our lord and liege, knowest thou of a youth named Amri? He is hollow and will join thee in wedlock. A fellow of mine guides him at this moment. When the time is ripe, thou mayst make thy salutations. For what lord taketh no spouse?
And by the tome we are going to give to Carla. Remember, don't give these tomes to Irina.
Till we meet again.
So that is done. Send Grey Rat to pillage Irithel.
Oh, hello. Fine work, I say. Discovering Irithel in the Boreal Valley, all in a day's work. If the tales are true, it is home to old moon-worshipping nobles, and should be packed with treasure. What do you think? Shall I go and see what I can find? A fine choice. I am Grey Rat the Thief. What I bring back will be worthy of that name.
Purchase from him. He will only return when Pontiff has been defeated.
I will leave for some time. So long for now.
All right, let's continue. Right, return to the Church of Yoshka bonfire. The assassin is still there. And we're going to kill two enemies. But first, take a right. And this is an online playlist. We've never searched it. It's supposed to show the high-ranking players in the Covenant, Dark Moon Covenant. So you can check that out if you wish. Now we need to get two enemies first before going into this area, because we will be invaded here by Creighton, the NPC. He will be dropping his weapon, which has lightning, so we're going to be using that weapon. That way we don't need to infuse the claymore with lightning. And let's take out the second enemy. Don't pick up the items, we'll get them on our way out. Go straight to the right, take out another enemy before we get invaded. crater. Pyromancy against such enemies are powerful. He has 2 Estus Blasts. He's already out, so he's using the Zeke Brow. And then he's down. That's his axe. We can now pick up the items. We will be returning to the shrine to burn this shard and upgrade the axe. So this little section is complete. Where we came from. Let's just take out 3 dogs and an enemy here and we'll get back to the bonfire. So next time around we'll sprint through this area. Let's just change this ring. And remember to always change your fire clutch ring. So this weapon is not doing a lot of damage. Let's change that. You see, each enemy has its own weapon needed. Lure 1 dog at a time. Remember to let the dog attack before you attack. Dog. Dogs are very vicious in Dark Souls 3. There's 1 more dog to the left. Remember to take out enemies before picking up items. The items will still be there. They don't go away. So down this path is progress, we're not going there yet. Back to the bonfire and travel to Phalanx Shrine. We have a bone to burn and a weapon to upgrade. Strength now is +7, which is good. Regarding the Estus Flasks, if you don't have enough shards to upgrade Dragon Slayer's axe, don't worry about it. Just infuse your other weapon with lightning.
Ah, well met.
It does more damage. Going to take it up to 6. Five rather. It does not look like we can upgrade any other weapon or staff or bow. We might upgrade this soon, because we're using the shield a lot. As I said, if you don't have enough to upgrade the Dragon Slayer's axe and Grey Rat has gone pillaging, just infuse the weapon you're using with lightning and we'll continue. Let's travel back to the Church of Yoshka Bonfire. And the assassin is still there. So we don't have to kill these enemies again, just run past them. We did this section when we got invaded by Creighton, the NPC. So we'll be going down this path. It's quite dark in here. There are a lot of enemies. They are invisible and they camouflage themselves. So take care. You can detect them by their bright eyes. Let's put on a torch. Try to take out as many enemies as you can from these stairs before going down. It's a bad idea just to go down and think you can take them out. There are other enemies on the parapets above. They will drop on your head. They inflict dark damage. So as many enemies as you can take out from these steps. There are only a few items in this dark area. There's a chest above. And we got that one. Let's take out some enemies above. When you feel it's coming to you, just pull up your shield. Take it out with your weapon. So a short weapon would be okay in this area. Long ones hit the walls and deflect your attacks. Remember, below a weapon there's where your menu is, where your flasks are. There's a red bar. It shows you the durability of the weapon. It might take a little bit of time to take them out, but it's safer this way. You will die if you just barge in and swing your weapon. Remember, in Dark Souls 3 you need some strategy. And you have to be patient, very patient. It's considered a difficult game. It is a difficult game. But if you take it safe and take your time, the rewards of the game is fruitful. and all these enemies and where each item is will become more familiar when you go, if you ever go to your second playthrough or your third and fourth. You can go up to NG 100, which is New Game 100, but the highest soul level you can reach is 802. You can't go higher. That's the maximum. Now, don't get me wrong, the game does not become easier at soul level 802. It's just that you now know where an enemy will jump out from and what weapon to use against it. It's not that you get good, as they say. I mean, if you are not careful, you will get killed in soul level 802. Now, the best pickups are in New Game Plus 3. You get a lot of new items to pick up, so it's worth going to 3 at least. And don't forget, you can always change your character. You can create new characters to play. You can always play online with friends. The moment we're speaking, in 2019, August, the servers are up and running for this game. What the future holds, we do not know. That is up to the creators. But for now, Dark Souls 3 is running strongly. Okay, use a torch here, it'll help. So we managed to kill every enemy down below and on the parapets here. So we're free to pick up the items. Drop down on this wooden platform to the right. The chest you'll find is a safe chest. There's no mimic in it. Alright, and let's leave this dark dungeon, you could call it. We will be dropping down on a small platform here, but there are two enemies coming up the steps here. You can see them. There they are. You can kick with the forward key and the attack key at the same time. In fact, it doesn't usually work for us, it's just by chance we kick now. It's a peculiar action, and there's no binding key for the kick. Okay, there's a little ledge here, drop down on it. In New Game Plus, remember this little ledge, because there'll be a ring here that you can't get now in your first playthrough. If we have enough requests from viewers, we will do New Game Plus 2 and 3. We will see how it goes for the absolute beginner. Now, we can't target this enemy from up here, we have to drop down. Alright. Two more enemies ahead. always pick up items after you've killed enemies. I mean, when you know you're safe. Well, let's go ahead and pick up the blood gem. There should be two remaining enemies, or three rather. They were all hiding in these alcoves. So there's two more, let's take them out. And then the last archway is an illusionary wall where you'll find your crystal lizard. Remember, if you don't get it, reload the game and it will appear in the exact same area. You don't have to sit at a bonfire or travel to another place. So the last one on the right, on the left, roll through and get your crystal lizard. This section is complete. Now we drop down, but it's the same, you can come by the steps also. That's the dark dungeons we came from. Down the steps and to a different area. For the next enemies, we need a more powerful weapon, so we'll change that to our claymore. Two-hand your weapon, a shield is not needed for these enemies. Change our rings. If one of those enemies drops anything, it'll be a green blossom. The area is filled with them. So this is a good farming spot for the green blossom if you want to collect those. They do raise your stamina and need. Let's take out two enemies here. Do inflict poison or toxin, I can't remember. I think it's poison. Now let's get the great heal. You can use this. It's not that soothing sunlight, but you need 45 intelligence, if I remember correctly. Now, if you didn't kill the enemy when we first came into the Irithyll on the bridge, it will appear here in the water. So it's good to try and kill it on the bridge. First part of Irithyll will end with this video. We will continue searching Irithyll in our next video. That's progress. We are going to light another bonfire. And conclude it here. And we will see you next time for the remaining area of Irithyll. Thank you ever so much for watching. And we will see you soon.